giving credit where credit is due. Errol Spence Jr. is a real one. He's a real one, whether you like it or not. This man is fighting Sebastian Fedora, a guy that can arguably be beat him at this stage of this man's career. Errol Spence Jr. is a question mark right now. He's probably thinking that he's a question mark right now. He don't know where he's at. We don't know where he's at. His last fight, he got beat down by Terrence Crawford. And here he is stepping into the ring with a 6'4", you know, guy that is arguably a damn machine. Sebastian Fedora throws a lot of punches and some hard punches too. Say what you want about him getting knocked out by Brian Mendoza. Still didn't change the fact that Sebastian Fedora is a tough fight for anybody. Especially when a fighter is coming off of a long layoff and getting beat down at that before the layoff. Errol Spence Jr. is a real one. And I don't think you get enough credit for being a real one. Errol Spence Jr., since he became a world champion, now it's back in 2016 or 2017, he's only faced one mediocre opponent in Carlos Ocampo, which was his mandatory. The rest of the fighters were either world class or world champion. Errol Spence Jr. don't duck any smoke. Say what you want, but his track record shows that he doesn't duck any smoke. Oh, John Boxing, he ducked Terrence Crawford. No, he did not. He did not duck Terrence Crawford. And I hate that narrative. I hate that you got people on YouTube pushing that garbage narrative about the PBC duck somebody. People lie. They lie, but want their lie to sound like it's the truth. They'll lie so good to make people believe that their lie is the truth, when reality is not the truth. Anybody that's pushing that garbage about how the PBC ducked a specific fighter are lying. Because if you look at the PBC fighter, which in Errol Spence's case, he's been fighting guys that could beat him. So it doesn't make any sense for him to duck someone when he's been fighting guys that could beat him. Sean Porter came close to beating Errol Spence. And even on paper, Errol Spence wasn't a heavy favor. Yes, he was the favor, but people were giving Sean Porter a chance because of Sean Porter's track record against world-class fighters. So Errol Spence were fighting guys that could beat him. So how can he be called a duck when he's fighting someone that can beat him? Al Heyman's fighters are losing to each other. If the PBC are ducking specific fighters, then why are the PBC fighters are losing to each other if the PBC wants to protect their fighters? That's the dumbest narrative that I've ever heard. And it's the biggest lie ever told. Business is what got in the way from Crawford and Spence fighting early on in their careers. Business and business only. But Errol Spence did fight Terrence Crawford, and that's all what matters. And he got beat down by Terrence Crawford. And now look at what he's doing. He's fighting Sebastian Fedora. Errol Spence Jr., even coming off of long layoffs, has fought top competition. I wish he would have never gotten that car accident. I wish Errol Spence was a little bit more responsible when he left that club. Because I think that car accident took a whole lot out of his career. Errol Spence Jr. after that car accident, he stepped into the ring with Danny Garcia. Danny Garcia, a guy that can crack, a guy that was ranked in the top five at the welterweight division. And Errol Spence fought the guy coming off an 8 months of recovery from a car accident, a brutal car accident. Fought him and beat him. And then turned around and was scheduled to fight Manny Pacquiao, who was coming off a great win over Keith Thurman, who was undefeated at that time. And what stopped that fight between Errol Spence and Manny Pacquiao from happening was Errol Spence's eye. Errol Spence went into surgery, got that eye fixed, and fought the guy that beat Manny. Some people here in this community was picking your Deniz Ugas to beat Errol Spence because of Errol Spence's inactivity. being sidelined, having surgery on his eye, and then to come back and beat a guy badly who beat Manny Pacquiao. And then another year goes by. He comes back and fights Terrence Crawford and got beat down. Terrence Crawford is smart because Terrence Crawford got a fight in before he fought Errol Spence Jr. Errol Spence Jr. didn't get a chance to get a fight in. Activity matters. Inactivity is any fighter's kryptonite. Errol Spence Jr. was inactive before he fought Terrence Crawford. And he's been inactive since he fought Terrence Crawford, and he'll be scheduled to fight Sebastian Fedora next year. I mean, how can you not respect someone like Errol Spence Jr.? How? Usually fighters will be talking about tune-up fights. But not Errol Spence Jr. He's a real throwback fighter. A fighter that doesn't get enough credit for wanting to fight the very best at any circumstance. Errol Spence Jr., he's all right in my book. I respect Errol Spence Jr. a whole lot.